And here we go. It begins. Welcome to the Camarillo Christmas Parade, 56 years strong. Camarillo, California, beautiful weather for another installment of a wonderful parade. I'm Spencer from 103.3 The Vibe, your morning show host, The Morning Rush. Happy to be here with...
I'm Dave Randall from 95.1 KBBY, your midday companion as you work the hours away.
And as you're watching this throughout the holidays, hopefully not working too hard, we know that this is shown all throughout the holiday season, and it's a great way to keep that Christmas spirit going in your homes.
We're full of festive thoughts today. We've just seen an extraordinary flyover from the Air Force, the commemorative Air Force planes, three abreast flying across the sky, a cerulean blue sky, as the great Vin Scully would have said, doing Dodger games. It's a beautiful day in Camarillo. Yes, we had a rough, wet week, but the weather is perfect for our parade today. Yeah, it's going to be a beautiful day. The sky is blue. The weather is going to warm up, regardless of what I have on right now. And here we go with the Ventura County Sheriff's Motorcade to kick off the 56th annual Camarillo Christmas Parade.
It is possible to have two motorcycles shining their lights on you and still have that Christmas spirit. This is not a rearview mirror. This is your television, and it's how things start. The Ventura County Sheriff's Motorcade kicking off the 56th annual Christmas Parade. Excited. This is an event for me that really kind of kicks my holiday spirit into high gear.
It certainly is festive. We've had a week of inclement weather in Southern California and very hard but needed rain. And today we've been blessed with this beautiful, beautiful morning in Camarillo as the officers greet the onlookers from the sidewalk. As you can see, we'll soon see the official banner from the PVRPD being carried by staff and volunteers.
And as Dave mentioned, we've got fantastic weather, and good thing as well, a lot of balloons in this way, in this parade. You know, it's not the only Christmas parade in the biz, but we've got hands down the most balloons.
That's true.
Yeah.
And they're not going to be buffeted by winds today at all.
And historically, we've gotten lucky. I don't see the high winds at this particular event. But we do see the kickoff with the Pleasant Valley Recreation Park District banners coming down, being carried by staff and volunteers.
We can look forward to all of the great local marching bands from the local high schools in the Ventura County area. We can look forward to some great automobiles, vintage and new. And we can look forward to seeing a Grand Marshal today who is quite the sports star in the history of Southern California.
Mini horses, people. If you like mini horses, stay tuned for that. And a batting cleanup on this whole deal is Santa himself. Dave, have you walked a parade? Have you been in parades?
I've been in too many to count. I've been in vans, and I've been in automobiles. I've been on the sidelines for quite a few parades. And of course, to go back to childhood, when you go to the parade in Pasadena, the big Rose Parade.
I've actually been in this booth while you've been in this parade.
I recall that day.
I know what you look like going by. It's nice to see you in the booth.
I was waving. I'm glad somebody recognized me.
Moving on, we have the Camarillo Christmas Parade 56th Annual Commemorative Banner. Again, the Pleasant Valley Recreation and Park District staff and volunteers are making that possible. That banner, unable to make it down the parade route without human assistance. I don't know if that's a fact I need to point out.
But if it starts moving on its own, we've got a problem. It means the winds have picked up.
Or a viral hit. We're ready for that.
And a hardworking staff they are at the PVRPD. I'm thankful to them for all of their assistance and having this happen this morning.
This parade brought to you as a joint effort between the Pleasant Valley Recreation and Park District and the City of Camarillo and the Ventura County Sheriff's Department. Details regarding the parade can be found on the Pleasant Valley Recreation and Park District's website as early as July. They are going for it. This is their event. The Recreation and Park District begins accepting parade applications as early as July. And their website for all of this, pvrpd.org. That's pvrpd.org.
So, Spencer, how many years is it now that you've been doing the parade on television here?
I'm guessing. I was going into today and I was thinking about, I think, 7 or 8. My co-host historically has been a like yourself, a 95.1 KBBY disc jockey, except for the 1 year it was Tracy Lear of KYT News Channel 3. So there's a standard, and then when they need to replace that, they're able to go up the ladder.
I see. I take that as a compliment. Thank you very much.
And for the record, for those of you that that don't know and haven't heard about K-Earth 101, you've heard them on there, and in a long history in the area of broadcasting. Do you want to roll the roster while we have a minute?
Oh, the credits. Yes, 20 years at K-Earth 101, and before that, mm-hmm. what used to be Q105 in the early days, back in the late 80s and early 90s. A lot of fun that was.
Back when it was only maybe the 23rd Camarillo Christmas Parade, but here we are, 56 years down the road. And still going strong.
Onto your screens now come the Vietnam Veterans of Ventura County Color Guard. Defending and promoting veterans' rights, the Vietnam Veterans of Ventura County awards the Staff Sergeant James M. Ray Scholarship to Ventura County students continuing their college education. They serve on the Veterans Advisory Committee for Congresswoman Julia Brownlee and State Assembly Jackie Irwin.
And the Color Guard in full display.
Followed by a very colorful bus.
I'll level with you. They did not give us a lot of information on that bus. I'm waiting to see what pans out. That bus is in the shade right now.
I know. It's very Partridge-esque. For those who remember the Partridge family. And who can escape those reruns on television?
Well, not while you're on Channel 10, I think. Watching this, they're happening somewhere else. All right. There's our decorated bus. Making its way down the parade route. In tow.
We can go with more veterans. Looks like the cavalry division. Air cap.
Followed up by the Ventura County Sheriff's Posse. Here come the Ventura County Sheriff's Posse. We're giving them a big welcome today, led by William Ayub himself. Posse comprised of volunteer members. They're dedicated to the principles of good law. Enforcement, public safety for the citizens of Ventura County. They work in direct support of the sheriff in various areas, including search and rescue, other missions under the direction of the department's mounted unit. The posse also involved with many other activities in the area, and they thank you for your support, and they're always fun to see at events just like this.
Great horsemen they are, too.
The sounds of thundering down the parade route. None other than the Adolfo Camarillo High School Marching Scorpions. Tough to miss that fantastic stadium right there as you make your way down the grade.
No, you can't miss it at all.
The scorpion on display. The Marching Scorpions are one of nearly 15 performing ensembles performing at Adolfo Camarillo High School. Let's go ahead and take a listen to the Adolfo Camarillo High School Marching Scorpions.
Marching Scorpions, by the way, Spencer, supported by the ACHS Music and Boosters. They're extremely grateful for their tireless efforts to do what it takes for the students. And, of course, the football team this year was strong. When a scorpion lowers its tail, look out!
What? I've been watching the monitor the whole time. I didn't see any tails. I will just enjoy a cup of glitter in the meantime. Should I? We have these fantastic cups, by the way, that... Great plug for the Pleasant Valley Recreation and Park District, pvrpd.org. And I imagine you can call them anytime. I imagine they have voicemail technology, 482-1996.
Now you know what makes Spencer go in the morning, an enormous cup of glitter.
That's got layers to it. I'm gonna have a tough time living that one down.
Go-go juice.
Making their way down the parade route is the first of many balloons that we're going to be seeing today. We've also got the FFA lined up and ready to go.
They, too, from Camarillo High School. More Fighting Scorpions, this time representing the FFA, providing students the opportunity to interact with skilled professionals that specialize in all areas of agriculture in order to capture and engage students. They will develop premier leadership and personal growth while preparing for college or a career through the FFA.
You rattled off a whole lot of vehicles that you've gone down parade routes in. Tractor, sir?
It is an agricultural area.
Have you ridden a tractor down a parade route?
I have not ridden
a tractor. Put it on the to-do list. You're wasting valuable time here in the booth.
I'll have to get my John Deere in order.
One of my favorite entries, the Topa Topa Flywheelers, which are coming up down the... It's It's one thing to be stuck behind a tractor when we've all had that when you're going down a two-lane road in our area, but when you see them out here on the parade route, big fan at that point.
It was possible at one time to get caught on Rose or Rice Avenue behind a tractor.
One time it being yesterday?
No, several years ago when there used to be one-lane highways each way, you would get stuck behind a tractor from time to time. And at that particular time, agriculture being the main product, the main source of gross national product, I suppose, in the, not national product, but a local product in Ventura County.
Still is. It's, I believe, one of our very few billion-dollar industries. Number one, agriculture still. I believe strawberries still tops. Boy, the avocado's coming.
They're both, and both about as big as the candles we have in front of us today. Huge strawberries.
You mean as big as the cups full of glitter we have
That
today.
Is correct. Strawberries being the only fruit with its seeds on the outside. Something that'll get you through a game of Trivial Pursuit.
Yeah, that tractor is green. That'll finish the game for you.
From Peterson Ranch.
Star Balloon carrying the PVRPD Star Balloon. Boy Scout Troop 858. The troop is 25 years old. If any of those scouts are, you're not applying yourself at that point.
Well,
no,
cool.
Just kidding. As a long time Boy Scout history and scouting, I always love to see these guys out there. Chartered by the Peace Lutheran Church. They meet on Sundays from 4 to 5:30 p.m. They go on camping trips once a month, including week-long summer camp. That's what I'm talking about. Troop 858.
It's a Mustang, and look who's in that Mustang. It's Bob Kelly, Robert Buddy Kelly, and his wife Kathleen. Lifetime Ventura County residents. They moved their family of six to Carrillo in 1988, along the same time I moved to Ventura County, and spent many happy years raising their children and participating in local sports programs.
Say hello to Elaine Magner, PVRPD board member. Elaine and her family live in Camarillo since 1985.
So we've all essentially been here since Kim Wilde had hits.
Oh, that's when you were kids in America. Sorry, that took me everything to make that connection right there.
Early Rocky films.
Mike Mishler, PVRPD board member, not Mike's first year in the parade. Mike has served on the PVRPD board of directors since being elected in 2012 and reelected in 2016. Re-election, that's good news for the work that Mr. Mishler was doing.
We might also note that these luminaries are riding in Mini Cooper convertibles.
Riding down luminaries. Luminaries. That is a fantastic word. Been doing I've been doing this event many years. Luminaries, first time out. Good job.
I went to school.
Who goes to parade school?
Hey.
Here's a cup full of glitter. Neil Dixon. All right, Neil Dixon and his wife Janet. They have five sons. They've lived in Camarillo since 1986. Neil, the 2017 chairman of the Pleasant Valley Recreation and Park District Board. Mr. Mark Malloy, PVRPD board member. Mark Malloy and his wife, Kathleen, moved to Camarillo with their two sons in 1982. Been active in the Camarillo adult and youth sports since 1984. Director Malloy, appointed to the board in 2006, and elected to four-year terms 2008, 2012, and 2016. Putting it all together, Mr. Mark Malloy. Merry Christmas.
Oh, here comes a festive song played by the Pleasant Valley School District Band and Choir. Enjoy this holiday music. You'll recognize it as Jingle Bell Rock. And they came to a conclusion.
Yeah, yeah.
But they've got another one in store.
Hit the lights, kids. Again, you're tuned in to the 56th annual Camarillo Christmas Parade. A beautiful day here in Camarillo, California.
One might say that every day is a beautiful day in Camarillo. Yes, you get some needed rain, but it's always a beautiful blue sky ahead, isn't it?
Pleasant Valley School District Band and Choir. Making their way down the parade route, the Camarillo Ranch Foundation, full-blown 501c3 nonprofit organization dedicated to preserving the historic home, grounds, and legacy of Adolfo Camarillo, our city's namesake. Hay bales in the truck.
And festive hats.
A spectacular carriage, white horses.
Yes, the Camarillo white horses, the official horse of the city of Camarillo. The horses, white from birth, being ridden by riders in traditional Spanish costumes. This unique breed traces its history back to 1921 when Don Adolfo Camarillo purchased his first white stallion, Sultan.
And with those white horses and the carriage, in keeping with the fairy tale Christmas theme, which is set up as part of our 56th annual Camarillo Christmas Parade. Thanks you again for tuning in. My name is Spencer Fisher. You can catch me every morning, at least weekdays, on 103.3 The Vibe.
I'm Dave Randall. You can catch me 10 in the morning, Monday through Saturday, on 95.1 KBBY. Today's hits, yesterday's favorites. And today, a beautiful day for a Christmas parade.
Today, I'm wondering how you got the day off of the one to do the other.
I have some influence. I believe coming into view in a Mini Cooper convertible that's blue is our mayor, Kevin Kildee, mayor of City of Camarillo. Kevin's been serving Camarillo as a council member for over 20 years, accompanied by his wife, Janet. They've got two lovely daughters, and they wish us all a Merry Christmas, and a Merry Christmas to you, Your Honor.
Is mayor Your Honor?
Sure, His Honor.
Okay, I honor up judges.
I'm sure you have.
Yes, absolutely. I didn't know I was supposed to honor up the mayor. Kevin Kildee passing your screens right now, part of the 56th annual Camarillo Christmas Parade. Beautiful Camarillo, California on a sunny day.
And followed on the city hierarchy will be the vice mayor from the city of Camarillo, Tony Tremblay, and his wife, Kathy, a retired Pleasant Valley School District teacher. They've lived in Camarillo since 1983. They have three adult children. Tony's a local attorney serving his first term on the council, and he wishes everyone a happy holiday.
That's the power of parades, by the way. Your young kids, you better put me in. Come on, Dad, put me in. But when they're adult kids, don't forget to mention you have three adult kids.
Of course.
I want a piece of that parade, too.
It's all in the family.
Tony Tremblay coming by. Kicking things off today with a fantastic flyover. I'm going to say I don't remember that being part of the presentation. We had a kick things into high gear with an official flyover.
Well, it's appropriate, as close as we are to Camarillo Airport, to have some sort of fantastic aircraft fly ahead to get things going today.
I'm glad you put that as appropriate. I thought it was a fantastic addition. We've kicked this thing into high gear. If you missed it, it's going to re-air all throughout the holiday season. You can catch the flyover, which was the kickoff to our Camarillo Christmas Parade.
Also in a Mini Cooper is a council member from the city of Camarillo, Charlotte Craven. A council member for 32 years, since 1986. She's accompanied by her grandson, Trevor, who just celebrated his 8th birthday.
Happy birthday, Trevor. Do you remember your 8th birthday?
Yes, I do. I went to Dodger Stadium for the first time when I turned 8. Saw the Dodgers beat the New York Mets. Osteen versus Cardwell. Al Ferrara hit a 2-run home run. Dodgers win 2-1.
Yeah, my kids don't remember their 8th either. That's cool. That was... He had a play for play. And let's go back and let's take a look at the replay of the 8th birthday. You had every move.
You remember things like that in your life. I remember entering the stadium and seeing that green grass for the first time because it was terrific. Here's somebody who probably remembers his 8th birthday just as well. Sean Mulcahy, council member from the city of Camarillo. He's one of Camarillo's newest council members. Just took office this week. Congratulations, Sean. Born and raised in Camarillo, graduated to CSU Channel Islands. He's accompanied by his wife, Katie, who's a third grade teacher in the Pleasant Valley School District. And many, of course, know Sean for his work with Brendan's Irish Pub and Restaurant Chain and his family's ownership of Donna Lee Donuts, which is now Rolling Pin Donuts. And you're talking to two people here familiar with donuts.
Well, you really put your back into that, too. Rolling Pin Donuts. All right. Susan Santangelo, council member, City of Camarillo, newly elected to the City Council. Merry Christmas to you, Susan. Thank you for stopping by and looking great in the Camarillo Christmas Parade.
She's a registered nurse.
making their way down the parade route. You've got the banner. You've got the Pleasant Valley School District Chorus. Pleasant Valley School District celebrating its 150th anniversary this year. On behalf of the students, they wish all of those in the community a very happy holiday season. This is one of many musical entries that we're going to get throughout, but I'm going to say tough to beat the cute level, which is going to be coming with this one.
Yeah, what a thrill for the kids to be out here and singing carols and celebrating and getting the holiday season started the right way. Singing Feliz Navidad y Prospero Año y Felicidad, niños.
See, they've got them all holding on to the to a ribbon so they don't wander. Nice move. A very Merry Christmas from the Pleasant Valley School District.
All the kids, teachers too, and a giant elf, as I dressed in green we just saw.
The school district is a big district, and it's a big entry as well.
A lot of years too, 150 years.
Proud to see the low fatigue level at this point with that age group in the parade route. Still going strong. Clearly aware of the cameras.
Oh, yes.
We've got your elevated view. We've got your street level views. Coming to you live from the corner of Las Posas and Arneal here in Camarillo on a beautiful sunny day, part of the 56th annual Camarillo Christmas Parade. And the noise can be heard over the chorus of the young kids out in front of them. That is the Newberry High School School Panther Band.
Marching Panthers.
Newberry Park High School Panther Band under the direction of Dennis Crystal, led by drum majors Marley Davis, Shannon King, Dasha Manzos. And the Panther Band proudly joined today by the 7th and 8th grade band students from Sequoia Middle School, directed by Carla Stevenson, Sycamore Canyon School. And Mr. Crystal would like to thank all of the dedicated Panther Band parents who work so hard to support their kids. Let's take a listen. Some power on that Newberry Park High School Panther Band.
Ah, yes. Music from the Nutcracker.
Okay, Kelly Long. Now approaching the Ventura County 3rd District Supervisor, Kelly Long. Kelly, now completing her second year in office, along with her husband, Stu, appearing in the Camarillo Christmas Parade and looking great in that Mini Cooper convertible.
Looking forward to another busy and exciting year as she continues to serve the county and District 3.
Dr. Erica Beck, president of the California State University Channel Islands. We have Echo in there. They're local, they're the mascot at local public university, celebrating its 16th anniversary.
That looks like a vintage Chrysler. If I have my cars correct. Love to see the vintage cars in the parade, by the way. Just absolutely love them.
I was going to give you Mopar no matter what, but you committed to Chrysler. So I was, I'll let him run with that one.
Have you ever had a root canal?
Yes, go on.
Well, Anna Kappa oral surgery is on the way. Marwood Stout DDS is an oral surgery practice that has competed in this event for many years. And here they are. That appears to be a Beamer.
BMW, I'm going to go X3? You going to give me the X3 on that
one?
There
you go, yes.
If it's an X5 and they go by, oh, darn it. Get you next year, guys.
But out of the T-top comes a great oral surgeon. One must always be nice to oral surgeons.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. I'm not picking a fight with my oral surgeon. No
way. I don't
think
so.
No, thank you.
This won't hurt a bit.
And great weather once again for the 56th annual Camarillo Christmas Parade here in the corner of Las Posas and Arneal is our vantage point. We have the street level. We have the elevated view.
And I might add, this is being the 56th annual parade. Last year, of course, was a postponement because of the amount of ash and smoke in the air. And it certainly is great to see things resume in such a tremendous and festive way. You can really feel the spirit in the air today, a Christmas to go along with the sunshine and blue skies. Christmas in Camarillo.
And for those on the slow rebuild process on the other side of that fire and the mudslides, just so you know, still doing Christmas with my blue 805 Strong band on, just to let you know. Haven't forgot about the rebuild process as well. Cub Scout Pack 3877. In a magical land far, far away comes the Camarillo Cub Scout Pack 3877. Hauled by Silvera Transport to a gingerbread wonderland.
Now that's a truck.
That is a truck.
That's a truck. That's a house-moving truck. No, literally and figuratively, they could probably move a real house as well as this gingerbread house we're seeing right now.
That's also a gingerbread house.
Yeah, imagine chowing that down.
I've already been doing that while you were talking.
No, some of the icing is missing.
I would start on the corner of the roof and just be there for the next couple years.
You were a scout, correct?
Yes.
So you know that the scouts are having a great time today.
I can tell you our gingerbread house was nothing like that. So amazing job, you guys. Amazing. Cub Scout Pack 3877.
Look who's on the way. The Thousand Oaks High School Band, the Marching Lancers. With a rich and diverse history of performance, with over 170 members in the department, 35 band members performing in today's Camarillo Christmas Parade, going to be traveling to Rome on December 27th to perform in the 2019 New Year's Day Parade in Rome, and on January 1st in Vitalazio. My Italian is not very good. The Vitalazio, Italy, January 3rd.
Why travel? They are probably the loudest entry so far. Rome can hear you from here. Amazing. Take a listen. Thousand Oaks High School Lancer Band. That is the hydration vehicle there at the end of the band.
Hydration vehicle.
They just pour it right into the tuba. You drink while you go. And making their way down it is the Pleasant Valley Lions Club. I am proud to say I am a former vice president of the Santa Barbara Lions Club. I love my Lions. Always excited to see Lions out in the community being of service. Part of our fairy tale Christmas theme this year. And laid into it, the lion and the mouse. Not sure I caught that fairy tale, but I'll go with it. Never too small to make a big difference. Oh, of course, the paw and the thorn in the paw.
We know the thorn in the paw.
The
yes,
thorn in the paw. Best. All right. The Pleasant Valley Lions Club wishing everyone a very Merry Christmas. And you can hear the Ooga horn right there. I've been part of the Lions Club. That was the kid with the new horn.
Yeah, you know, it may well be some indigestion. Maybe it could be.
Have you heard the horn on Billy's horseless carriage?
It's the Ventura County Model A Ford Club. Very soon, what will come into view are these vintage automobiles. Almost 5 million Model A Fords were built in the 4 years between 1929 and 1932. And my father owned one.
Yeah, these youngsters get in here with their newfangled cars and just muddy up a otherwise good Christmas event.
Oh,
look at them tearing up the streets.
These whippersnappers are just, you know.
Leave some asphalt for the rest of us. Come on.
It's Tokyo Drift time with the Model A Fords.
Slow it down. There's people on the side.
The club's mission is to encourage interest and to preserve the history of the Model A Ford. A wonderful automobile, as I said. My own father's very first automobile, a Ford Model A. Mine was a Pinto. His tastes had changed by the time I was in high school.
I had a blue oval as my first as well. A four-cylinder turbo Mustang, sir. Mm.
Two or three engines later, still on the road.
That's a lot of noise. That is a squad of fire trucks making their way down the parade route. I'm seeing the Rio Mesa High School cheer team.
There they are. Ventura County Professional Firefighters Association, and of course the cheers from the Rio Mesa High School cheer team. If I'm incorrect, correct me, the Fighting Raiders. Am I correct?
For Rio Mesa?
Yeah.
I don't know enough to speak against you, so I'm going to go with the bet.
But there they are in fighting form, ready to cheer on their team, the Firefighters.
And really, there is nobody that lives in our area that does not feel the same thing when they see this passing by their house or their place of business. It's that element of protection and pride, and you always wave, and that's that wave back that you'll get from the guys every time you do, our Ventura County Firefighters. Done fantastic work on the Hill and Woolsey fires. Thank you so much.
Along with the Krumpka family wishing us all a Merry Christmas, the 28th year they're in the Camarillo Christmas Parade. What is that I see in yonder distance?
Well, you see a snowflake balloon for sure, but you're also seeing it being carried by members of the Pleasant Valley Recreation and Park District lifeguards, the lifeguards that work at Pleasant Valley Aquatic Center, which is celebrating its 50th anniversary next year. They had water in there before you were not allowed to have water in your pool in Southern California, that is. That's what skateboarding got the big advent, when they were cutting back.
Ah, yes.
Where have you seen any of the Dogtown lords or other?
I have not. But I do know that empty swimming pools are a great skate park.
Absolutely. And full swimming pools, even better.
Oh, no. Well, if you have a surfboard, perhaps you could pretend or float. Sing a Beach Boys tune and have a wonderful afternoon.
And you're getting the snowflake that associated with winter, but short sleeve t-shirts because this is Southern California.
Right. This is where we wear shorts and flip-flops in a driving rainstorm.
I did that just last
week.
Yes,
you did. Where do you think I got the mental image?
And from all of the staff at the Pleasant Valley Recreation Park District, they wish you a wonderful fairy tale Christmas. Of course, that is the theme of this year's parade, fairy tale Christmas.
And don't forget, at the end of the parade is Santa's Village at the Camarillo Community Center. You're not going to want to miss the festivities there. Lots of fun for all the family.
And I'm just going to put it in for those of you watching the rebroadcast throughout the holiday season. Stay on your couch. Keep enjoying the program. The carnival has wrapped up since he's sending people to the... Go now. You know what? If you want to spark up your own Christmas festivities on the quarter...
The memories hang in the air.
Yeah. Cub Scout Pack 3753... on wheels, making their way down the parade route, part of the 56th annual Camarillo Christmas Parade.
They're from Newbury Park, with scouts from kindergarten to fifth grade. Ranks from youngest to oldest are lions, tigers, wolves, bears, and weebaloos. When I was a scout, it was way below. That's what I was. Wasn't a scout for very long.
Did you get out, but did you get any of the good stuff? Any of the camping, any of the summer camp, any of that?
No, I did not.
One meeting?
My sister was a den mother, though, so it, you know, somebody in the family succeeded at scouting.
Cub Scout Pack 3753.
Another one of our great local high schools represented here in just a few moments. From Wainimi High School, the Fighting Viking Marching Band and Auxiliary. Coming in the distance here.
Help me out with auxiliary.
Well, it means that there's some auxiliary units to it. There's
direct
could be
support.
Pep units. There could be color guard. There could be banner girls, as we see. There could be tall flags, short flags. Mm-hmm. This would be the auxiliary to the marching band, the pep units.
Yeah. Didn't know if it was direct support, like you have in desert racing. You're like, this is where the spare parts are. If a kid goes down, we put another one in.
They are not spare parts.
Oh, gotcha. No.
They're all a part of
the award-winning Viking Marching Band and Auxiliary, proud to represent Wainimi High School once again in the Camarillo Christmas Parade. Their costumes, part of the imagination and creativity. They're hoping it helps make your fairy tale Christmas an enjoyable reality. The Wainimi High School Viking Marching Band and Auxiliary.
The Fighting Viking Marching Band. As all high school mascots are fighting.
I'm thinking of my high school mascot and thinking of putting the word fighting in front of it. It's funny.
What was your high school mascot?
Pioneer.
The fight. Yes, they fought a lot, Pioneers. Yeah, did. Choosing traditional carols. Good King Wenceslaus.
Instruments decorated. Waistlines decorated. I caught that tutu there. And the Vikings making their way down the parade route.
You say you were a Mustang driver at the outset of your driving career?
Well, that was my first car. I got to take it away pretty much, about as fast as you were out of Scouts.
Well, here comes the Tri-County Mustang Club.
There was always a 66 or a 68 in the driveway, though. My dad built these all the time.
Those
Beautiful.
Are the best. This looks like a 65 or 66 right here, and they are fun to drive.
That is still a 65 or 64 and a half.
This man knows his vintage cars.
I'm going somewhere in 96-ish. Yeah.
This is a more recent one. The
Cobra?
Tri-County.
It's a Cobra.
Yes. Tri-County Mustang Club. For anyone who loves Ford Mustangs like Spencer here, they welcome all model years and members of all ages with cruises and picnics and car shows. And they host their own charity car show at the Channel Islands Harbor every October that benefits Guide Dogs of America.
Beautiful 66 right there. You could really hear that one just rumbling. Which, out of that 289?
There it is. There it's like he heard you.
Woo, we'll take some of that. Thank you for the Tri-County Mustang Club. Director's Award.
The Director's Choice Awards went to the Mikasa Girl Scouts. 2.6 million strong, 1.8 million girls, and 800,000 adults who believe in the power of every G-I-R-L. Go-getter. Innovator, risk-taker, and leader. Girl, to change the world. And the Director's Award, the Director's Choice Award this year, goes to them.
Congratulations, ladies.
We have an acrobat on the route. This would be the festive spider walk. Do you see what I'm seeing?
Complete with that walkover? That was amazing.
Wow. A contortionist.
I'm going to say a Camarillo Christmas parade first. We've been covering this a while.
You haven't seen anybody walk like a tarantula before.
This is a first.
That was amazing.
More Girl Scouts, the Mikasa Girl Scouts, coming down the parade route.
Congratulations, girls.
The green vests, all those badges and patches on.
Honored winners of our Director's Choice Award today. I still can't get over the contortionist. That's we saw a circus act right there.
And should you continue to watch, batting cleanup on this circus act is Santa himself looking forward to it.
Although I don't think he'll be crawling like Daddy Longlegs Spider.
Camarillo Roadrunners are celebrating 50 years of youth football and cheer and coming down the parade route here at the 56th annual Camarillo Christmas Parade, looking fantastic and bringing the Christmas cheer.
50 years of youth football and cheer. How about that, huh?
And you're tuned in to the 56th annual Camarillo Christmas Parade. Thank you for joining us. It'll be airing all throughout the holiday season on your televisions. I'm Spencer from 103.3 The Vibe. You can catch me on weekday mornings, host of The Morning Rush.
I'm Dave Randall, Bible 95.1 KBBY, today's hits and yesterday's favorites, 10 in the morning, Monday through Saturday.
We've got the 17th Bomb Wing Korean War veterans making their way down the parade route right now.
Spencer, the purpose of this group is to honor the Korean War veterans and their impact of saving a nation from the enslavement of communism. In addition to preserving peace and freedom, they also recognize and remember the prisoners of war missing in action, 8,177, and the 36,000 who gave the supreme sacrifice during the Korean conflict.
And bringing some very cool military-grade vehicles to our parade today.
vintage. This coming entry will be the Holiday Spirit Award in the 56th Annual Camarillo Christmas Parade from St. Mary Magdalene School.
Our entry of the from the St. Mary Magdalene Parish and School, they've been a long been a part of the rich history of Camarillo. Built over 100 years ago, the historic chapel serves as a beacon to the faithful and all who call Camarillo home. Enjoying its 64th year. Serves as a landmark of faith, character, academic excellence to the city of Camarillo.
They've taken a pause that refreshes now as the parade kind of...
You've got the Holiday Spirit Award banner. And making their way down the parade route. St. Mary Magdalene School.
It's at this point where they take the pause to savor just a moment.
Or just extend that invitation to come check out their historic chapel. They're putting it out there. Swing by and see the wonderful school as well as the chapel, both located just steps from Old Town. Merry Christmas to you and yours. A Happy New Year from the St. Mary Magdalene School, where dreams become realities.
It is a beautiful chapel, too. Nothing quite like the sight of a chapel like St. Mary Magdalene that make you really truly feel the warmth of the holiday.
Cape Charter School. That is the Camarillo Academy of Progressive Education. The acronym laid out, Cape Charter School, a local public charter school that serves students in grades K through 12. The charter has been in existence since 2007, currently sporting 580 students and a high volume entry.
That packed truck looks like all 580 are there right now.
Let them rock. Cape Charter School, the Camarillo Christmas Parade.
Someone's coming into port. If you're getting a new electronic device for Christmas or have one that you don't know how to use, you can reserve a spot on December 27th for the Winter Tech Fair. It's at the Community Center. Helpful staff is going to show you how to use and operate those fancy new devices. You call the Pleasant Valley Senior Center at 482-4881 to reserve your spot today.
All right. We've got a Camaro sneaking around the back.
As most Camaros do.
Oh, they're so sneaky.
I believe these are more the kids from St. Mary Magdalene. Or the
Cape Charter
School.
Cape Charter School.
And that is a vintage Camaro. No, not a vintage. Is it?
Yes,
it's a vintage Camaro. Yes.
Probably 68. Possibly.
69. Yes, with a spoiler on the back.
And
another great Mustang.
It's either a 65 or 64, possibly a 66 with the forks removed. That's something I used to see in that clean line right there. I love custom, though. Nice job. There's some Mopar for you. Dodger Plymouth, what are you going to do with that?
It's a Chrysler product.
Okay.
And a Volkswagen.
You took a chance. You got lucky.
Of course.
You got lucky on that one.
Of course I did. All of these as a prelude this morning to the Oxnard High School marching band you can hear in the distance. After these beautiful vintage cars.
You'll have to explain to family that lives in other parts of the country why you get to be in a convertible for your Christmas parade.
In Southern California. Here they come. The Oxnard High School Fighting Yellow Jackets.
Boy, you will just put fighting in front of every mascot.
But they are.
I believe the Yellow Jacket could fight, though.
They can be mean at times, yes.
The Oxnard High School Marching Band coming at you full force, part of the Camarillo Christmas Parade.
A marching swarm. Thank you.
catching the 56th annual Camarillo Christmas Parade, an event that was kicked off by actual multi-jet flyover today.
That was a thing of beauty.
Spectacular on this beautifully clear day, and this program rerunning throughout the holiday season. If you missed the beginning, you can catch that. As well as, it looks as if this is the Ventura County Wolfpack making their way down.
Well, you know what this is.
Get ready, and if you are not ready, get down.
329, say it, hut, hut, hut.
Ventura County Wolfpack, an all-women's full-tackle professional football team.
Run-pash options all around, folks. 4-3 defenses.
Since 2015, ladies 18 and up are welcome to join in the fun of full-tackle football.
You might even see somebody stand in a three-point stance right now.
I was ready for it.
Could happen.
You sounded like you were running plays the entire time.
They could have.
Don't know if they have a Halle Berry play.
No, they don't. Omaha, Omaha. Halle Berry, Halle Berry. Call those audibles, ladies. Here come the Cub Scouts again. This time the Camarillo Cub Scout Pack 38-31.
One of the largest packs in Ventura County. And you can tell by the numbers they're putting up on the screen today. Nice job. Good show for us. Camarillo Cub Scout Pack 38-31. I appreciate the Raptor art. I've gone many Christmases without people putting a Raptor into the mix. The Pleasant Valley Recreation and Park District is an independent special district formed in January of 1962 under the State Public Resources Code of California. The district, located in and around the city of Camarillo, serves a population of over 70,000 and covers an area of approximately 45 square miles. And everybody within that square mileage has come out to turn up your holiday spirit and put on a fantastic parade and a show all throughout the holidays.
Yes. Well, you know, it's never too early to think about New Year's. The Pleasant Valley Senior Center is going to be hosting an end-of-year bingo bash Sunday, December 30th. Doors are going to be open at 11 a.m. Games will start at 1 p.m. This will be the best bingo game in town for adults 18 and over. You visit www.pvrpd.org or call 805-482-4881. And you know those bingo folks, they could go all the way to the strike of midnight in 2019.
Operator, connect me to the bingo game. Or go on the internet.
Give me Madison 62666. That's Madison 62666.
As I understand it, a pretty special performance coming down the parade route right now with the dance company serving Camarillo since 2010. Located just behind the Camarillo Ranch House, the dance company offers professional instruction, jazz, ballet, tap, lyrical, hip-hop, contemporary. Training beginners to professional, two to adult. This is the dance company coming down the parade route.
Performing to Brenda Lee's Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree.
Recorded when she was 13. Well, that it was recorded when she was 13. Yes. Re-recorded. Let's take a listen. The dance company's on our screens.
And we also have our own booth by Santa's Village where we're doing free glitter tattoos. So please stop by if you'd like. Now give it up for our talented dancers!
It's the Beatles!
Thank you. An amazing performance from the dance company, and making their way down the parade route right now, the Grand Marshal banner and our Grand Marshal himself.
Oh, it's Anthony Davis, AD number 28, for the USC Trojans. From 1972 to 1974, Davis was the lead rusher in the Pac-8, averaging 4.8 yards a carry. 6 touchdowns versus Notre Dame in 1972. A spectacular comeback against Notre Dame in 1974. Should have won the Heisman Trophy.
Can't
AD.
See it from here. A Nike gold Nike swoosh pin on him, too. I got the up-close shot in the pregame.
AD's quite an athlete. He also played on the baseball team in some national championships for the...
Hot dog, it's Mini Horses. Mini Horses making their way down the parade route. You can't see a Mini Horse and not smile.
No, you could mistake a Great Dane, but those are Mini Horses.
School, Triton Marching Band, and Color Guard making their way down the parade route, part of the 56th Annual Camarillo Christmas Parade. Under the direction of Kathy Rogers, they strive to participate in a variety of community events and parades, so you may have seen them before, but you have not seen them like this. The Pacifica High School Triton Marching Band and Color Guard.
Pacifica High, one of the newest high schools in Ventura County. Coming along only sometime in the last 20, 25 years, if memory serves me correctly.
With that fancy solar power.
Fancy. It's the Dune Buggy Club. Look at that, the Manx Club. You know that a Manx is a cat with no tail.
I was thinking that was a lynx.
A Manx, a cat with no tail, but the Manx Dune Buggy Club is a group of dune buggy enthusiasts.
Without tails.
I would guess that would be a physiological feat in and of itself, I think. The Manx Dune Buggy Club, owner of a street legal buggies with members located throughout the United States, Canada, Europe, and Australia. The Manx Club is a family-friendly club hosting events ranging from scenic highway driving to off-roading in the desert and mountains.
A lot of love, unless you try to be liquid cooled. Then they're like, no-ho, air cooled only, buddy.
The original dune buggies, of course, stripped down Volkswagen Beetles. The great Steve McQueen had a dune buggy that he would take to the beach. A daring actor was he, Steve McQueen.
Say they put smiles on your faces, but the vehicles themselves look like they're smiling. So they'll do the work for you. The Manx Dune Buggy Club.
It's all in the look, all in the action.
Fantastic paint jobs, fantastic modifications.
In Southern California before. Only in Southern California will you have a Dune Buggy Club in December.
Take that, Hawaii. Really spectacular, though. The customization and no two of these are the same.
How about Bruce Myers, the creator of the first ever fiberglass dune buggy, 1964, touching a chord with fun lovers and off-road racers alike. He's 92 years young. More smiles per miles is his credo.
It's a great way to do it.
I believe we have a mouse from another house on one of these buggies, too. There's Mickey waving at you.
The big waves. And joining you through the holidays, part of the Cabrio Christmas Parade, the Manx Dune Buggy Club. How many dune buggies would you guess we've seen so far? This is a fantastically large entry.
I haven't counted.
But every time that camera pans back, there's another dune buggy.
More.
I could do this all day.
You'll note the turn key at the top of each one, too.
Mm-hmm.
Not necessarily how a dune buggy runs, but in the early days.
Making their way down the parade route, the Camarillo Chamber of Commerce Man and Woman of the Year. We got Mr. Chris Messner and Woman of the Year, Jan Huling, wishing everyone a Merry Christmas. You can see Jan in the convertible right there.
They've taken to the luxury vehicles for the luminaries.
She's rocking out to her own music or music provided on the side of the of the street, but rocking she is.
It might be coming out of the Blaupunkt. Something festive. I believe there's a man and his child over there who are getting their groove on, or their swerve, right now. Because that's what parades are all about, having fun and getting your swerve on.
I was going to go with the groove thing. If you want to bring it in the swerve on, fantastic. Next year, I'm going full swerve on.
You got to.
I didn't know I was allowed to.
Right.
And there, I believe, is this Chris?
Yes.
Yes.
Preceded by Jan.
They are your Camarillo Chamber of Commerce Man and Woman of the Year.
I know this is going to excite you, no doubt. We have more dancers on the way.
I'm up for the action. I'm up for the music. Okay? I came for the flyover. I'll stay for the balloons. I'll definitely stay for Santa. The Dance Alliance of Camarillo making their way down the parade route. The Dance Alliance of Camarillo dedicated to offering quality dance instruction to families desiring affordable tuition rates. They want every child with a passion for dance to be able to pursue their dream. It's like the movie Footloose on a local level.
On a local level. Except that dancing is always legal here.
The Dance Alliance of Camarillo.
Sort of a R&B festive version of a sleigh ride danced to by the Dance Alliance of Camarillo.
Followed now, by Tony's Pizza and Rocket Fizz, two fantastic outlets in our area.
You can't go wrong either way.
The magic intersection between those two, Ron Goodson, the owner of both Tony's Pizza and Rocket Fizz. No bad days, I guess.
No bad days at all in downtown Camarillo. They've been there for years. You can stop by for a unique soda or a great slice of pizza. I think that's on my menu for later today.
Thanks, Tony.
Happy Camp Cobbs Gypsy Travelers. Happy Camp Cobbs Gypsy Travelers, presenting Jack Frost as Wonder Wonderland with Happy Camp Gypsy Cobbs of Moorpark. Jack Frost, played by Jade Zaccaro, on Lord Duncan, Winter Horse.
Are my eyes deceiving me, or is that a Clydesdale? Yes.
So I'm guessing that's Jade and Lord Duncan right there. Those two seem pretty compatible. I have not seen... This is a whole lot of stuff I have not seen.
On winter horses.
56 years strong, still bringing you a bunch of firsts. The Camarillo Christmas Parade. Happy Camp Cobbs, Gypsy Travelers. No cars. They will take about two weeks to get home from
They
this.
Are astride their mighty steeds. And that is not the man walking his dog I described earlier. That was just a gentleman from the neighborhood. This is a man who is actually participating in today's parade, and his dog is getting exercise, too. As the Amber Light Lions Club comes into view.
More lions. Fantastic.
They present the Grinch Who Stole Christmas with the doghouse and the dog Max, sharing the activities, wishing everyone a Merry Grinchmas.
A large Max. You are hardly Grinchy if your dog is that large.
Oh, hey. Spencer Buzza.
Here to join the parade and celebrate the season with everyone. Joining Spencer, his mom and sister, young niece, nephew, his riders, the art car was custom built by the driver, Spencer Buzza. Did it for Burning Man. the parade today.
Those are big wheels.
Yeah.
You have to be a big wheel to have big wheels like that.
Team in his image, encouraging all people to come out and enjoy a healthy lifestyle, regardless of their challenges or abilities. Also honoring friends who are dedicated to improving the quality of life for our friends with mobility issues, celebrating the joy of being part of team made in his image. You can hear the Meadows Arts and Technology Elementary School Band. This is fantastic. You're in elementary school, you play an instrument, and the song sounds like the song. Amazing.
They're very talented.
I love it.
And enjoying every minute of this 56th annual Camarillo Christmas Parade. They've stopped in front of our location to say hello. With a wave and a smile.
These are first and second year musicians in the fourth and fifth grade. Meadows Arts and Technology Elementary School Band, fourth and fifth graders, rocking down the parade route.
Followed closely by University Preparation Charter School at CSU Channel Islands. These are dolphins.
Fighting dolphins? Are you going to do it?
I would imagine so, even though the dolphin does not fight. I saw an episode of Flipper once where he almost got into the mood. But this is the student leadership team for the University Preparation Charter School here in Camarillo. The excitement for learning, being student advocates and role models make the UPCS community special. They sure know how to have school spirit. Go Dolphins!
All right, it is a 2017 or newer Camaro. I'm going on that one.
I'd say.
Convertible Miss Ventura County, making her way down the parade route, Jacqueline Pizza. And Miss Culver City's Outstanding Teen 2018, Nicolette Sickmiller.
Always happy to see the beautiful contestants, the winners representing
Jacqueline Pisa right there on your screens. Convertible Camaro. You're looking at Miss Ventura County. Outstanding Teen 2018.
Name this vehicle a Fiat?
Nicolette Sickmiller in the back. That is our Miss Culver City's Outstanding 2018. Culver City on the screen. Moore Park and Simi Valley Scholarship Organization making their way down the parade route. Teen Gold Coast, Olivia Hymas, and Simi Valley. Anaya Prasad, Teen Moore Park, Catherine Huntsman, and Miss Moore Park, Ariana Brooks, and Miss Simi Valley, Olivia Sickmiller. The Sickmiller girls, not their first year in these parades.
It's a bevy of beauty queens making their way in the vintage automobiles.
Journey the Church, year after year, it's tough to beat them with the volume. Journey the Church.
They love it loud.
Non-denominational Christian church in Camarillo's mission is to love the world one person at a time. The other mission, to rock the Camarillo Christmas Parade thoroughly every year. I remember the Journey of the Church entry specifically for this reason. They're put on a show for the television audience. Let's let them. Journey the Church, the Camarillo Christmas Parade. Journey the Church, holding services in the Camarillo Community Center every Sunday, 9 a.m. and 11 a.m. and Wednesdays at 7 p.m. Everyone is invited and always welcome to join.
A large and celebratory entry for sure.
We got another award winner making their way down the parade route, the sweepstakes award winner.
This would be Billy Clower Cheer, the Billy Clower Dance Studio, a full-service dance studio dedicated to providing Ventura County with top-quality instruction in a friendly, positive, fun atmosphere since 1953.
Generations of inspirational dancers.
What's the first dance you ever learned?
Ooh, I think it was, it was breakdancing.
Really?
Breakdancing was when I took the time, the effort. Then after that, anything Michael Jackson was doing.
If I say so, it's going to make me sound like I'm like the Crypt Keeper, so old. The Twist! Easily the Twist. Of course, this club predates the Twist.
I was the first one to move their finger like this.
No, this would go back to the Jitterbug.
Billy Clower Cheer.
Whether you'd like to pursue a career in the dance industry or simply love to move along to the beat, they look forward to working with you and making dance class the highlight of your week. Billy Clower Cheer.
Fantastic gingerbread house bat and cleanup on that entry. Mercedes-Benz of Oxnard. Surprise, surprise.
Ah, yes.
In Mercedes-Benz under the new ownership of the Greco family. Greco Family Motors wishing everyone a very Merry Christmas. And they have Mercedes just like the ones you're looking at on their mod.
Yes. Mercedes-Benz, the best or nothing.
Nice job. I know that guy from the radio. Say you're taking the car for a test drive. What are you doing with all that garland? Don't worry about it. The Isbell Marching Condors. The Isbell Middle School Marching Condors came today. Today's competition from Santa Paula. They've been a participant in the competition for many years, and they'll be playing the Flying Cadets March by Carl L. King.
I have not yet to hear the Flying Cadets March. This will be the first time. A maiden voyage for hearing this. Listen. Sounds very familiar, like Free Ride. Come on and take a free ride.
The Isbell Marching Condors, far from its extinct. That was a large number of marching condors down our parade route here.
I did not know condors could march.
Yes, yes.
When they're not flapping their 20-foot wingspan, they're marching. Yeah,
their wingspan at the end of that entry took up the entire parade route.
Yes, it did. Like an airliner.
Of course, you're tuned into the 56th annual Camarillo Christmas Parade right here on the corner of Las Posas and Arneal under blue skies in Camarillo, California. I'm Spencer from 103.3 The Vibe. You can catch me on weekday mornings hosting The Morning Rush.
And I'm Dave Randall from 95.1 KBBY, today's hits and yesterday's favorites. You catch me 10 through Saturday. That's why I'm so happy to be out in the sun.
And here on the parade route, this does show on your televisions all throughout the holiday season, so you pick the right channel. I'm guessing cable. And thanks for joining us. And for me, this is a big gear shift. I go into full holiday spirit after, spending this kind of time focused on Christmas activities.
Who could not be? You'd have to be Ebenezer Scrooge in the flesh, not to feel the spirit today.
Hopefully, we're pulling you along with us.
Especially with the Beacon Hill Classical Academy on the way.
Merry Christmas from Beacon Hill Classical Academy. Beacon Hill, a Christian school here in Camarillo, celebrating 10 years of classical Christian education. They're a growing, dynamic community of full-time and home-to-school hybrid students, parents, educators, serving grades K through 12.
And everybody's enjoying it. Festive eyewear, even, as you can see.
Beacon Hill Classical Academy.
Oh, I could go with a mojito instead of eggnog right now hearing that.
I have a cup full of glitter, so you're doing better than me.
That's what they call a mojito in certain parts of the world. They have a cup full of glitter, man. One love. Merry Christmas.
Beacon Hill Classical Academy. Bring some island flavor to sunny skies and Christmas festivities in Camarillo. The Point Magoo 4x4 Club. I always love to watch these guys.
You know, you think Point Magoo, of course, you think aircraft like we saw at the beginning of the parade. This, of course, a car club, a four-wheel drive club, family-friendly, dedicated to off-road issues and fun.
And good numbers this year for the Point Magoo 4x4 Club. I've seen a slim entry from them in the past. It's good to see some good numbers out here today, and I always love my 4x4s. I do own one myself, so I do take note.
They've come in force.
Nice job. Nice decorations. Nice ability to go from pavement to the dirt.
Yes. Where the rubber meets the road.
Beautiful.
Just a reminder that this parade is brought to you by a joint effort between the Pleasant Valley Recreation and Park District, the City of Camarillo, and the Ventura County Sheriff's Department. Need to know more? You can go to pvrpd.org.
This looks like Knight's Tactical Inc., family-owned gun shop. And they're way down the parade route. Right here in Camarillo, the shop carries survival gear, freeze-dried food, and has been nestled in the Paseo Shopping Center for 5 years. Come say hi, or check out all that cool tactical gear.
And freeze-dried food. I only have coffee crystals at the house. That's it.
Richard Cooten. Bringing us a 1957 Chevy Bel Air, and followed up by a 1923 Ford T-Bucket Hot Rod, which he also bought for his bucket list.
Oh, yeah, that Chevy's 50 years old, restored and beautiful. And look who's coming now. More festive music, the Santa Paula High School Cardinal Band and Color Guard.
Feliz Navidad, audibly rocking the parade route. And for the spectators on the side, they can hear it. For you at home, we're going to give you the opportunity here. The Santa Paula High School Cardinal Color Band and Color Guard.
Introduced in the late 1960s by Jose Feliciano, has become a Christmas classic. Feliz Navidad y Prospero Año y Felicidad.
None of that was on the paper. How did you know that?
Well, they don't give these jobs to chimps. Thank you. love the marching band arrangements of contemporary music. It's just great.
Look, I'm just happy to see that our parade entries pretty woke to the fact that this is a television operation. We didn't, in the years past, get them stopping and putting on the show for the audience viewing at home. We're getting that this year. They know we're here. They're putting on a show for you and excited.
They have an eye for the camera. And here comes the Ventura County Interfaith Community, representing the Ventura Interfaith Community, a 1932 Chevy Cabriolet driven by John Potter.
They know you're here. They're putting on a show for you. Chuck DeMart, driving an original 1936 Ford Phaeton. He wishes everyone a Merry Christmas, but mostly check out my cool car.
Oh, it's so
check
cool.
Check it out. Camarillo Cougars, youth football and cheer making their way down the parade route. Your Camarillo Cougars providing children and the community the opportunity to learn the game of football and the art of cheerleading to promote an atmosphere where all players and cheerleaders are taught fundamentals, skill training, tactical decision making, and position play. Their goal? To teach the meaning of camaraderie, team, and sportsmanship.
That's where it all begins.
Well, they seem to be good sports about the free ride down the parade route.
They're loving every minute of it.
The Camarillo Cougars youth football and cheer, bringing you a little extra Christmas cheer, part of the Camarillo Christmas parade for this year.
On our way now, Spencer, more vintage automobiles, this time the Bug, the Beetle, the Conejo Valley Vintage Volkswagen Club. Family-based club that participates in local events and fundraisers. They're also a great source of information to keep your classic VW running strong. Join them on second Sundays of the month at El Sancho Loco Park in Newbury Park.
The VW is a car that comes with, not all cars come with personality. They always come with a personality, and they're not afraid to dress them up or...
They look like the member of the family that wears the lampshade on their head. My father had a Volkswagen also. He had a number of automobiles.
Well, there's the lampshade.
There it is, yes. Oh, that's a hippie-mobile. That's where you camped out long before Woodstock and just communed with nature.
Well, who got to Woodstock a month early?
You'd be surprised who was on Yasger's farm before the music started.
There's another lampshade.
I understand they're bringing the bus back. Will be interesting to see.
And a Volkswagen always smells like a Volkswagen. Old or new, when you get into a Volkswagen, it smells like... I could be blindfolded. I could tell you I was in a Volkswagen.
Is it the upholstery that does it for you?
It's probably the upholstery glue or something that they use like that. Yeah, absolutely. The Shafter High School Band. Shafter High School Band proud to present their 2018 competition march. Joyce's 71st New York Regiment March. That's the information they give us, but these bands have more than just that in the repertoire, so we've been surprised before.
Stand up and cheer, nevertheless.
Shafter High School Band.
That is indeed the New York Regiment March. That is.
A theme award winner coming for us. This is another award-winning entry here at the 56th Annual Camarillo Christmas Parade. This theme award-winning entry, Habitat for Humanity of Ventura County. Habitat for Humanity, building affordable homes. Low-income Camarillo families, and two families will be getting those homes in 2019. Fantastic. Habitat for Humanity, Ventura County, they are your theme award winners. And the theme for this year, Fairy Tale Christmas, so...
A dream come true for those families.
Consider it brought.
Right. And they fulfill that theme. Habitat for Humanity of Ventura County.
Yep, some of the touching real-world effect is the two low-income families in 2019 will have houses or homes built by Habitat for Humanity.
It's a wonderful thing.
At the right time of year. The home sweet home signage, appropriate on the side of the entry, your theme award-winning entry of Habitat for Humanity of Ventura County.
Also involved there was Corey Douglas, a retired Army Staff Sergeant.
Taeryong Taekwondo, founded by Grandmaster Yongshin, a ninth degree black belt and a 2000 Sydney Olympic manager, head coach, has proudly served the communities of Camarillo, Newbury Park, Thousand Oaks, Ventura, Saugus, Los Angeles, Bakersfield, and the newest location, Port Orchard, Washington, and for the past 36 years, the discipline and the art of Taekwondo in the Taeryong Taekwondo Academy.
Safe to say he's been up and down the Pacific Coast. Teaching the arts. We'll get a demonstration right here.
Sending those boards flying. She means business. Christmas business.
No one's stealing her lunch money.
You can hear the cheers from the street and the crowd loving that one. A fantastic display. And again, proof positive, they're playing to the camera more. The best seat for this event may not be the one right across from us on the curb. I'm saying that the cameras are bringing you the action this year.
It was a great martial arts demonstration.
Taeryong Taekwondo Academy, part of the 56th annual Camarillo Christmas Parade. Good weather. We need it because we've got big balloons. And thankfully we have it again and again. And they keep bringing the balloons. We wouldn't get the balloons if this was a weather challenge every year.
Our friends, the lifeguards, are back with the Mother Goose Balloon. Carried by members of the Pleasant Valley Recreation and Park District Lifeguards. They work at Pleasant Valley Aquatic Center, which will be celebrating its 50th anniversary next year.
And preceding them, the Boys and Girls Club of Camarillo is the entry that's that is visible just in front of the highly visible Mother Goose balloon, the largest balloon I've seen so far. I don't know. They stand
in the shadow of Mother Goose. Of course, the parade with the big history balloons in New York City, which this year was marched in 19-degree weather. And fierce winds buffeting.
Macy's Thanksgiving Day.
That is correct. Now compare that to this beautiful pastoral scene. Even Mother Goose is surprised. She said, I was in New York, look what happened.
Is your Mother Goose impression?
Well, I never really developed a Mother Goose impression.
Who thinks to?
Yes, I'm just looking at, you know, basically the eyes and the kerchief and the attitude, and well, maybe, I don't know.
The attitude visible from several streets over with a balloon that size. Mother Goose and her attitude.
Have you done your homework yet?
Making her way down the parade route. The 56th annual Camarillo Christmas Parade. Spectacular weather and one giant Mother Goose balloon.
Before you could use a Q-tip, another on the way.
Wrangling down that balloon is our lifeguards, the Recreation Park District lifeguards, and making their way down the parade route now, the Santa Ana Valley High School Falcon Marching Band. I think you can put fighting in front of it.
Yes, you can.
Those fighting Falcons. Santa Ana Valley High School Falcon Marching Band been participating almost annually in the Camarillo Christmas Parade. Something they've pushed for more than annually, but we got that. We said it just needs to be at Christmas. They agreed. For the past decade, they've been part of this event. Please enjoy the Nutcracker as played by the Santa Ana Valley High School Falcon Marching Band. Tchaikovsky coming to you from the Camarillo Christmas Parade. Thank you.
the Dance of the Sugar Plum Fairies.
Under the direction of Joaquin Hernandez, color guard instruction, Coach Annabelle Marcial, and drumline instruction from Mr. Jose Aguilar. That is your Falcon marching band and color guard. A fantastic display. Christmas parade.
This is an entry from the Cornerstone Christian Schools. At Cornerstone Christian School, Castle, there are students preschool through eighth grade. I knew that horn was coming.
You timed that out fantastic. Many of the semi-trucks have semi-truck parts. These guys... That's train horn, okay? That's train.
Trains are coming.
And the fairy tale Christmas theme, very much played out by the Cornerstone Christian School entry.
With a lovely medieval castle.
Up next is the Camarillo Methodist Men's Club. In addition to their own, they're hosting a return of parade favorites, the Starline Central Car Club, devoted to both screen-used and replicas of famous TV and movie cars. So we're going to see stuff that you know.
That's Knight Rider, right?
No, that's Burt Reynolds. Smokey and the Bandit.
Oh, Smokey and the Bandit. Okay.
Okay.
There's a glare on my screen.
There's a glare.
This is a Lincoln Continental.
Many famous from The Matrix, and everybody else uses that. We got a Chevelle.
Yes.
Or Malibu.
A vet, of course. A pink vet.
Pink vet looks like something Angeline would have sported back in the day. Her office is right next to our radio offices in Ventura.
It's Austin. It's Austin Powers.
The Jaguar, baby.
Groovy.
Wow, they got the Jaguar. How was the Christmas parade this year, Spencer? It was fantastic.
Anything new?
Yeah, baby.
And as you can see, Austin Powers himself, Dr. Evil, driving it right there.
Yeah. It looks like Mini-Me. $1 million.
Sir, $1 million isn't exactly a lot of money these days.
Peace, man. It's groovy.
And the most spectacular of all entries. I am sorry. Oh, that's a piece of... Oh, wait. Yeah, that's... I'm forgetting what movie that's from.
Pizza Planet?
Wait. All right. Herbie, on your screen right now. Go Ocho. From Toy Story. It was the Pizza Planet.
Yes, that's right. And of course, earlier.
Yeah, Black Beauty. The Camarillo Knights of Columbus and Padre Sarah Parish, the Catholic Gentlemen's Fraternal Organization, originally founded to protect the poor, defend the orphaned, the widows, and so much more. Knights of Columbus, a worldwide Catholic organization founded on the principles of charity, unity, fraternity, and patriotism.
Knights of Columbus followed closely by the San Gabriel High School Marching Band. They've come across two mountain ranges to be here today.
And thank you for doing so.
The San Gabriel Matador Marching Band. School, arts, sporting, community events throughout Southern California, they always make a great performance. As we get a close-up on the Knights of Columbus just preceding them.
Ooh, they better move it. That marching band is hot on their trail.
I noticed. They're moving at quite a clip.
This is as close to a high-speed pursuit as we've seen today. Stay tuned for the exciting conclusion. The San Gabriel High School Marching Band.
Performing to Portugal the Man's Feel It. Daft Punk.
Yep. Get lucky. We're up all night to get lucky. Amazing job. The San Gabriel High School Band making their way down the parade route here at the 56th Annual Camarillo Christmas Parade under blue skies. We started the event with a flyover. It'll re-air throughout the holiday season on your television. Do watch it again. The jokes only get better the second time around.
We could only hope.
Make their way down the parade route. The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, talented group of singers, going to be performing in tomorrow's first ever Christmas concert in the park, The Nativity. Not a better way to get into the Christmas spirit than experiencing the nativity as presented by professional musicians, including drumline, violins, bagpipes, jazz band, soloists, choir members, over 300 singers, including children, youth, and adults, giving a taste of all of the action that's going to be going into tomorrow's first ever Christmas concert in the park, The Nativity. Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. I don't try to bring my phone out of my pocket when I'm driving on the freeway, but every time I've been next to this particular Corvette, the phone comes out and you make Snapchat. Pizza Man Dan.
There's only one Pizza Man Dan, the man with the plan to put pizza in the pan, and here he is.
Is that... Yep, that's Dan.
That's not a vintage vet with the measles. Those are pizzas.
That's the real vet. That's the real Dan.
Always helping the community, always involved. This year, Pizza Man Dan's excited to be here and bring along four awesome vehicles. Wishing everyone happy Christmas. And a fine pizza. That's a nice pie he makes.
Boy, when he was a manager of another pizza outfit back in the day, it was my first meeting of that guy, and I just watched him expand and his empire grow. And
it's everywhere. It's a nice place to bring the family, have a pie, have what seem to be limitless drinks.
Yeah, and always a good time. And whenever you go to Pizza Man Dan's or anything that he else had started over the years, you're like, who gave this kid all of this money? Whew. It's like,
he earned a great deal of it with a great pie.
The Horizon Baptist Church making their way down the parade route here. Horizon, one passion, to grow in the grace and knowledge of God. They are here to place where the Word of God is taught, where people are loved, and the community can find real hope. Horizon Baptist Church coming down the parade route, part of the Camarillo Christmas Parade.
You know, we're not far from the magic moment.
We promised the people Santa. He has not failed yet. Batting cleanup, as promised. Santa Claus, moments from now.
I sense somehow, like Yasiel Puig himself, Santa will arrive. These are the Topa Topa Flywheelers.
One of my favorite entries. A slow tractor. Perfect for parades. When you're stuck behind one on Wainimi Road, oh, it's happened. There's nobody watching that hasn't happened to. The Topa Topa Flywheelers, classic, awesome tractors. That little flywheel exposed on the side. I don't know everything that there is to know about vintage tractoring, but...
Well, the primary purpose of the club is to collect, preserve, restore, display, show, and operate antique farm equipment and machinery.
But education's not in there, so I still... If I see that little flywheel on the side, I'm like, yep, they're probably in the club. No shortage of ag land in our area, and
nope.
I would think that with that, tractor culture. Some custom tractors. Tractor meets and car lots.
That's right. Strawberries, lemons, fields of arugula. Or the lettuce of your choice.
Watch Oxnard lower a tractor. Watch. I love the entries from the Topa Topa Flywheelers.
I've seen 4x4s with wheels like that.
I've seen a shopping cart with wheels like on the front of that. Just really amazing.
Agriculture, of course, being major industry of the county. Without it, where would we be?
I'm assuming these tractors have seen their share of hard work, but they are clean like they have not.
Little pine saw goes a long way.
I am learning more about tractors than I pine saw with the... Your Topa Topa Flywheelers. Moving on to the Redwood Middle School Viking Band. Getting started. You can hear the whistle firing them up. The Redwood Viking Band and Color Guard is under the direction of Mr. Adam Payne, assisted by Mike Freed and Joe Martoni. The band is made up of over 50 musicians from the Symphonic Band as well as the Color Guard members. The Redwood Middle School music program, known for its high level of musicianship and for consistently receiving superior ratings at festivals and parades, I imagine.
Yes. Past winner of the sweepstakes award in this parade.
The Redwood Middle School Viking Band making their way down the parade route. Now, I appreciate a tight musical entry like the Redwood Middle School Viking Band, but if one person knows that we're here, year after year, it is this next entry, and I really hope he plays it up to the camera.
The big guy knows all.
We've gotten double guns from him in the past, yet to see Santa break out a good dab, but he always plays to the camera. Santa, this year, last but certainly not
He knows
not
when
least,
you're sleeping.
But does he know where the camera is?
Well, of course.
We'll see. Riding on his fairy tale theme sleigh to wish us all Merry Christmas from here in Camarillo. Santa, you can see the camera right here.
Merry Christmas, Santa.
Santa Claus, the final entry here at the 56th Annual Camarillo Christmas Parade.
Spencer's stocking is waiting, Santa.
It's not already completely full of coal. I believe there's still some room in there. That's how I'll be running my fireplace throughout the holiday
As long
season.
As there's stockings and not nylons.
An amazing 56th installment of the Camarillo Christmas Parade under blue skies, new for this year. People really play into the camera, I gotta say.
Yes,
I appreciate
that.
And the flyover in the beginning was nothing short of spectacular. It's something that if you missed, you can catch as this program will re-air all throughout the holiday season on your television.
That's right, from the flyover to Santa himself, we've had a great time today under what we've repeatedly called these beautiful blue sunny skies in Camarillo. Couldn't have had a better day for the 56th Annual Camarillo Christmas Parade, Spencer. Great working with you.
You as well. And just a quick refresher before we lose them. You can catch me every weekday morning on 103.3 The Vibe. I'm the host of The Morning Rush and would be happy to have you.
And you can join me 10 o'clock every morning, Monday through Saturday, at 95.1 KBBY. Look forward to hearing from you.
From the corner of Las Posas and Arneal, here in Camarillo, California, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year from the Camarillo Christmas Parade. Take care.
Merry Christmas!